Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today I have something a bit different for you, or news from the enormous volcano Askja, where a magnitude 3.5 struck 2 days ago, and that is only a part of a longer chain of events that dates back to 2012. That is when we started to notice some changes there, and it was then in 2021 when land uplift was detected. It kept our scientists busy until August last year, when it slowed down, but never stopped completely though. And it was then just a few days ago when the land uplift took off fast, and the ground responded with a magnitude 3.5. So where is this leading to? This is no ordinary system. This is one of the big ones. And as for the history, the last eruption there was in 1961, and there were several eruptions there in the 1920s, all of them quite small, or when we compare them to the highly explosive 1875 eruption, that changed the landscape up there forever. Askja is in fact a complex of nested calderas, and in the middle we have Lake Askja, almost directly above the magma chamber that collapsed after the 1875 eruption. So Iceland's deepest lake is only 150 years old, and it's sitting on a reloading caldera. And what does that mean, might one ask? And we are a bit in the dark when it comes to how large events awaits us, and also when it comes to what type of event awaits us. But we keep on hearing the word explosive, and the 1875 eruption was indeed highly explosive. But back then, it was mostly pockets of groundwater blowing up, and to have one of the largest lakes in Iceland there now is, should we say, not making things simpler. And experts do not agree on how this will play out. Like it was during the tourist season last summer when one of our experts wanted the area evacuated. That was Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson. It turned out to be no need for it, but he was being careful and I respect that. And his statements got me actually a bit worried, or if I was getting the last chance to see this landscape up there and film it. So I took off to Lake Askja with a drone and captured the footage that you have been seeing now. And I still think that the professor had a good reason to warn us back then. But as for what scientists are saying now, Professor Ármann Höskuldsson was saying that Askja might be the next major volcano to erupt here in Iceland. And I believe him. So the media has been picking up this story quite seriously now. Even a Met Office, that is usually very careful, they were saying that this will probably end up with an eruption, as magma is probably accumulating there. But they are also saying that there is nothing indicating that there is something big about to hit us soon, and they tend to downplay things a bit. But Professor Höskuldsson, he was saying that there are no seismometers on the bottom of the lake, so we have in fact no idea about what is going on there, or between the bottom of the lake and the magma chamber. So in my opinion, he was trying to say quite nicely that there is room for errors in predictions that could turn nasty, like if Askja were to erupt during the tourist season, or can we be sure that we have time to evacuate? That might however be the case, like before and during the 1875 event, there was a major rifting episode, hard not to notice it. So we actually got plenty of warnings back then, but now we have a lake. So I have to ask myself, what if something happens between the lake and the magma chamber? And how much magma is there? I've heard 10 to 100 cubic kilometers. And that's quite enough to stir things up on the Icelandic Highlands. And this is only the short version of the Askja story. I made a video last year and linking to it, where I cover some of the basics and the history that might tell us a bit about the future. And the only solid conclusion that I have now is that we just can't say how the next eruption there will play out. I think it's impossible. And lucky us, those larger systems are far away from inhabited areas. But Askja did, however, manage to take our focus from the Reykjanes Peninsula for a while. Only time will tell if this was a teaser or a warning, but I think that we might be in for something bigger, and an eruption is just a matter of time. But again, I recommend the long video I made last year, since many of my viewers are hearing about this for the first time now. And my next update will be from the Reykjanes Peninsula. I just got back from a photo tour, and I'm hoping to get that one with fresh footage online tomorrow. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.